if you're a big internet user, you probably see. Oh, what?
Barbies. We're on Barbies.
Oh, right. Sorry, my bad.
Dolls. Not.
Oh, where are we? Oh. Sorry, English is my second language. Where? The most recent. Ah, yes. The most recent claim to fame of this year's winner is something that few people do: dress Barbie.
Go on. You did it.
Yes, I did. Mm-hmm. Yep. To celebrate this famous doll's 50th birthday last month, the services of New Zealand's best-known fashion designer were called upon. Of course they were. She outfitted the Mattel doll in 5 mini versions of designs that she had just shown at New York Fashion Week.
Yep, showing in the Big Apple is no mean feat. She is the only New Zealand designer to have ever had a solo show at this prestigious fashion event and has shown her casual women's wear collections for 6 seasons there. She was also the first New Zealander to show at London Fashion Week back in 2002. Furthermore, her collections are stocked in, I'm told today by her, that there are now 350 stores, not 250 as we first thought. Celebrities who have worn her designs include Madonna, Bjork, Claudia Schiffer and Drew Barrymore. And publishers Fiden and Tashin have included her in their recent books of the world's most influential designers. The only NZer ever to be represented. She also receives fantastic editorial coverage, including regular pages in American and British magazines such as ID, Vogue, Teen Vogue, Elle, W and Nylon.
Wow, and she lives in Swanson, West Side.
Mm-hmm. Forever.
The threads are great, and the fabulous names of her past collections are well worth sharing with you tonight. Liberal and Miserable. Mm-hmm. The Society of Bright Young Things. That was a personal favourite. Living with Cannibals and Other Adventures. Young, Willing and Eager. And Queenie Was a Dog.
The latest one is She's Cracked.
Ah.
That's what it's called.
Nice. This clever creative has also designed 3 collections for iconic Kiwi outdoor brand Swan Dry, and she has collections of eyewear, jewellery and even paint that sell both here and abroad. At home in New Zealand, she supports the Breast Cancer Research Trust and the World Society for the Protection of Animals by designing T-shirts for their fundraising campaigns. And she's also worked with Air New Zealand on their program to bring new talent into the fashion industry by mentoring them on the international fashion stage. We welcome and invite Mayor of Wellington, Kerry Prendergast, to the stage to present this award on behalf of the Wellington City Council.
Prime Minister, the Honourable Tim Grosser, distinguished guests, good evening. I'm honoured and proud on behalf of Absolutely Positively Wellington City Council to present the Creative Industries 2009 World Class New Zealander Award to Karen Walker.
Thank you, Kerry.
Do you want me to hold it for you?
No, I can. You can hold on to it. In the business we're in, every time a customer buys something of ours anywhere in the world, whether it's a $15 little brooch or an $8,000 string of pearls, it's an acknowledgement that we're grateful for and that we never take for granted, and that means a great deal. And this acknowledgement also means a great deal to us, because we hold the judges in such high regard, because the winners this year and in past years are so extraordinary and awe-inspiring, and because the idea of these awards is about making an impact beyond New Zealand and creating a brand, a business, a reputation globally. And that is what our brand has been about since day one, almost 20 years ago. So thank you, Wellington. Thank you, Stephen, for having the vision for Kia and for these awards. And thank you, Stephen, Craig, Jeff, John, Perry and Peter, our judges, for this most wonderful award. We are very honoured. Thank you.